Do subscribe to Ikeda channel and press bell icon to get updates about latest engineering, HSE and IIT JEE main and advanced videos.
Last lecture we have studied three numericals which are based on numericals which are based on Faraday's first law, and now we are going to do another one. So let us see how can we deal with it. So as mentioned in above your screen, as you can see, a question which is based to what current in ampere will be required to produce 2.369 into 10 raised to minus 3 kg of copper from copper sulfate solution in 1 hour. And how many moles of electrons are required when the molar mass of copper is given as 63.5 gram per mole. So the first thing that we have to do is we have to extract the data as well as we have to convert those data in a proper unit so as we could get a proper answer. So the answer that we could get will be a perfect one. So before doing that one, so let us see that we should convert this kg into gram, because all the weight that are being deposited on the particular electrode gets deposited in terms of gram, and when it comes to the timing, it is present in 1 hour. This 1 hour should be converted into seconds, and then only we could be very much precise to the answer that is the requirement for us. So let's see, the given data says that we have the weight or the mass of the copper that has been deposited to us, that has been given to us, and that has been deposited is 2.369 into 10 raised to minus 3 kg. So this can be converted into gram also as 2.369 into 10 raised to minus 3, where kilo is nothing but 10 raised to 3 gram. This will cancel out each other, and the answer that we could get is 2.369 gram of copper. The next one is they have said that the time required was 1 hour. So therefore the time which is mentioned as 1 hour should be converted into minutes. So therefore 1 into 60 minutes, that can be converted into seconds also. So eventually we'll get an answer as 3600 seconds. And lastly, they have given us the molecular weight. So therefore the molecular weight of copper, they have been mentioned here as 63.5. So with the help of this data, we could estimate what would be the current, that is what would be the value of I when this kind of data is given to us. For that we know the formula, W is equals to Z I T divided by 96500. But before evaluating what would be the value of I, we don't know what is the value of Z. So we know that for copper sulfate gets dissociated in the form of Cu2 plus plus SO4 2 minus. Therefore the valency of the copper is 2. So I could write it as Z is equals to molecular weight divided by valency of the metal in ionic form. So therefore the molecular weight which is given to us as 63.5 divided by the valency of the copper that is we have got is 2. So this will give us an answer of 31.75, and with the help of this we could estimate what would be the current required to give this value. So therefore the W that they have provided to us is 2.369 gram, which is equals to Z, that is 31.75 into current which has been asked, into time, and the time that is what they have provided to us is 3600 divided by 96500 coulombs. Therefore I is equals to 2.369 into 96500 divided by 31.75 into 3600. So if we calculate this thing, we could get an answer as 2 ampere. So this is how we have got the value of current. But the next question is also remaining. They have asked that how many moles of electrons would be required in this reaction. So let me tell you, the weight that has been deposited in this electrolytic process is 2.369, and from that we could estimate what would be the number of moles of copper. So the number of moles of copper will be weight of copper divided by molecular weight of copper. So from that sense, the weight which is provided as 2.369 and the molecular weight which is given as 63.5 will give us an answer of 0.037 moles of copper. But they have not asked that how many moles of copper are being produced. They have asked how many moles of electrons are being involved in this reaction. So let me tell you that one copper, when it is in solid form, it is giving us a valency of 2 plus, means Cu2 plus is, means copper is converted into Cu2 plus by eliminating 2 electrons. So therefore, if one mole of copper is been oxidizing or is undergoing oxidation to give 2 moles of electron, therefore if 0.037 moles of copper, and in each case one copper gives 2 electrons, therefore the 0.037 moles of copper will give 0.037 into 2 moles of electron, that is 0.0746 moles of electron are being involved in this process or are being oxidized by the copper metal. So this is how we have calculated that how many moles of electrons are being involved in this reaction. So thank you friends for watching this video. I hope you have liked this video, and please share this video with your friends, and yes, don't forget to subscribe to EGRA channel. Thank you so much.